We are still continuing with sexually transmitted diseases. Modrik's is my name. But specifically for this video, we are going to look at the urethral discharge syndrome, which is common in males. And even females can have this, but it's common in males. So we are going to look at this urethral discharge syndrome. As I earlier told you, in sexual transmitted diseases, we use a syndromic approach. We base on a number of signs and symptoms, and without making investigation or waiting for results, we start the management. So the first syndrome among the symptoms we have seen in the previous video is urethral discharge syndrome. What happens here? There is discharge coming from the urethra meatus. As you are seeing this other person, there is pus coming from the urethra. And you are saying maybe frank pus, maybe real pus, mucopurulent or clear or serous. But something is coming from the urethra. We are saying urethral discharge from the glans penis. As you are seeing, from the glans penis, this other tip, there is some discharge, which is whitish as you see here. And occasionally, we are saying discharge will be white in color. In urethral discharge syndrome, the color of the discharge most of the time is white, pus-like discharge. What causes this urethral discharge? One is gonorrhea, and that microorganism will be Neisseria gonorrhoeae. So people have gonorrhea. You will see this urethral discharge, which is white in color. Still, in people who have trichomoniasis, which is caused by a protozoa Trichomonas vaginalis, also they possess this white discharge. And other non-gonococcal urethritis caused by the virus, which you call virus-like bacteria, mycoplasma, and chlamydia trachomatis. So we are seeing three conditions now, and that's why I told you in a syndromic approach, we don't first look in details to do investigation to understand whether it is gonorrhea or trichomoniasis or urethritis. The issue is, once we see a white discharge, we see this urethral discharge syndrome, then we are going to start management. Whether it is gonorrhea or trichomoniasis, we don't want to first screen out. And that's what we call it syndromic approach. What are the clinical features of someone who has urethral discharge syndrome? The patient complains of mucus or pus appearing at the tip of penis. There is burning pain on passing urine, which you call dysuria. Painful micturition or burning pain on passing urine. And when examination is done, we are going to see a scanty or a profuse discharge on the tip of the penis. Some glands will have Bartholin abscess, that is pus in the Bartholin glands. Others can have gonococcal arthritis, inflammation of the joints due to having gonococcal infection. If it is in the babies, these babies are going to have ophthalmia, neonatorum. If it's in neonate, you can have conjunctivitis. Then there is chlamydia, pneumonitis, otitis media, and genital ulcer. These are some of the clinical features of someone who has urethral discharge syndrome. And this can appear in a child who is born of a mother who had urethral discharge syndrome. And some of other clinical features can be tubal ovarian abscess, that's abscess in the fallopian tube and the ovary, pelvic abscess, It can also lead to ectopic pregnancy as another sign. And we are saying trichomoniasis, yellowish froth or offensive veg discharge, and it irritates. So because of this, there is painful coitus, which you call dyspareuria. This person will have issues, pain during coitus. There is redness of erythema mucosa because there is damage, so that it becomes red because the microorganism is damaging it and as a result of inflammation. So how can we manage a client with urethral discharge syndrome? We are saying something to remember. Both the patients and sexual patterns must be treated. Remember, this is a sexually transmitted disease. In management of urethral discharge syndrome, if you manage only maybe the wife or only the husband, still the condition will remain, in that the other part will bring the condition back. So we are saying, as you manage sexual transmitted diseases, keep it in mind that both parties must be treated, the husband and the wife. And this is the treatment you are going to use. One is efficacy, 400 milligrams as a single dose. You can add doxycycline, 100 milligrams, 8 hourly for 7 days. And we are saying, if the pattern is pregnant, are we going to use efficacy and doxy? We are saying no. In the case the partner is pregnant, and I've told you are going to treat both partners, we are going to use erythromycin, 500 milligrams, 6 hourly for 7 days for this pregnant partner. And we are going also to talk about the issue of discharge. If the discharge or this dyspareuria persists and the partners are treated, what are we going to do? We are going to exclude them. If there is no ulcer, we are going to repeat doxycycline, 100 milligrams, 12 hours for 7 days. And we are doing this in the case the dyspareuria persists. And we can also add metronidazole, 2 grams as a single dose. If we do this, this pattern with urethral discharge syndrome is going to improve. We can also do the following, that in case still it persists and the partners don't get treated, we are going to give ceftriaxone, 1 gram as a single dose. And in case the patient still has issues, now we are going to refer to a specialist. Thank you for listening. That has been how we manage a client with urethral discharge syndrome.